Hi, good day. This is Miss LM and we're back again for another math video, and today we're going to talk about linear inequalities in two variables. So before we proceed to the definition of linear inequality in two variables, let us have this question first. What comes first into your mind if you hear the word inequality? Ano nga ba yung unang pumapasok sa isipan nyo kapag narinig nyo yung salitang inequality? Yes, it means not equal. May mas malaki, may mas maliit. And what are the different inequality symbols that you already know except from the unequal symbol? We have this symbol known as greater than, this symbol as less than, and then we also have this symbol greater than or equal to, and ginagamit siya kapag meron tayong nakitang salita na at least. So when we say at least, ito daw yung pinakamaliit. Or another term for this is the minimum. Kapag sinabing minimum, may mas malaki pa. So that is why greater than or equal to symbol yung ginagamit natin. Again, huwag kayong mako-confuse. Pag sinabing at least, ito yung pinakamaliit, kaya ang ating symbol ay greater than or equal to. Another is less than or equal to. At ginagamit naman siya kapag meron tayong nakitang words na at most, ito daw yung pinakamalaki, ito daw yung maximum, kaya malamang sa papaliit siya. At most, maximum, ang gagamitin nating inequality symbol ay less than or equal to. Now, let us try to use the different symbols. So let's fill in the blanks with the appropriate answer. So tingnan natin kung natatandaan nyo pa nga ba kung kailan dapat gamitin ang greater than or ang less than. So we have here 5 and 0. What inequality symbol should we use? So correct, that is greater than. Next, we have negative 3 and positive 3. Alin nga ba ang mas malaki? Pareho silang 3, pero yung isa ay negative and the other one is positive. So we all know, 3 is greater than negative 3. That is why kung ganito yung ating comparison, negative 3, blank 3, so this should be less than. Next, we have 0 and negative 8. So we all know that 0 is greater than negative 8 kasi negative values ay mas maliit kesa sa 0. So this should be greater than. Then the last one, negative 2 and negative 10. Alin nga ba ang mas malaki dito? Negative 2 o negative 10? So the answer is negative 2. So the symbol should be greater than. When it comes to negative integers, tandaan nyo po, the more na mas malapit siya sa 0 or sa positive numbers, siya yung mas malaki ang value. So, this is how we use the inequality symbols when it comes to integers. Next, let us try to apply inequality in algebra. Translate the following verbal sentences to mathematical inequalities. So the first one, the value of Philippine peso, which is represented by P, is less than 1 US dollar, represented by the dollar symbol. So ang nabanggit na mathematical inequality is less than, so P, then the less than symbol, then the dollar sign. P less than $1. Next, according to research, the number of female obese is greater than the number of male obese. So F for female, M for male, and nabanggit na mathematical inequality is greater than. So, we are going to use the greater than symbol, F greater than M. Next, number 3. The maximum capacity of a jeepney is 20 persons only. So, sabi ko nga po sa inyo kanina, when we hear the word maximum, pinakamalaki, so hindi na tayo pwedeng lumagpas dito, so mas papaliit pa siya. Kaya po ang ating inequality symbol is J is less than or equal to 20. So, pwede siyang maging 20, pero mas maliit sa 20 pwede. Next, number 4. We have here, a student needs a score S, at least 75 to pass a 100 item test. So, dito naman, at least daw, ang pinakamaliit ay 75. So, sa papalaki siya, we're going to use the greater than or equal to symbol. We have S is greater than or equal to 75. Number 5. 5 is less than thrice a number B added to C. So, sundan lang natin yung nasa sentence para makabuo tayo ng mathematical inequality. 5. And then less than symbol, thrice a number B. When we say thrice a number, we have to multiply it by 3. And then sabi dito, added to C. So, idadagdag daw natin siya sa C. So, we have here 5, less than symbol, we have to have C first. And ang idadagdag daw sa kanya ay 3B. So, we have here plus 3B. But since addition po yan, pwede natin unahin si 3B bago si C. Kasi it will not affect naman po the sign of those terms. Then last, we have here a certain number G subtracted from 12. So, tandaan po, subtracted from 12 is less than or equal to 4 times a number h. So, binawas daw natin si g kay 12 and then less than or equal to ang nabanggit na inequality and then 4 times a number h, so 4 times h. So, we have here 12 minus g is less than or equal to 4h. So, that is how we translate verbal sentences to mathematical inequalities. Para rin lang po tayong may mathematical equations, yun nga lang, inequality symbols ang ginagamit natin ngayon. Okay? So, next. Now, for the definition of linear inequality into variables, we have here, a linear inequality into variables is a mathematical expression similar to linear equation that makes use of inequality symbols such as greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, and unequal instead of equal symbol. It can be represented by any of the following. So, we have here, ax plus by is greater than c, ax plus by is less than c, ax plus by is greater than or equal to c, and ax plus by is less than or equal to c. Some of the examples of linear inequalities into variables are as follows. So, we have here, x plus y is less than 4, and then we have here, 3x plus y is greater than or equal to 3. We also have, y is less than or equal to 2x minus 3. So, parang written siya into slope-intercept form. Yun nga lang po ay inequality siya. So, y is less than or equal to 2x minus 3. Another is negative 3x minus 2y is greater than 6. And also, we have x is greater than or equal to 2y plus 5. Here are some of the examples of linear inequalities in two variables. Now, for the solution set of linear inequality in two variables, so it is the set of all ordered pairs x and y that satisfies the given inequality. So, same as sa linear equation, kapag nasatisfy yung equation, solution siya. So, ganun din po dito sa linear inequality in two variables. So, let us have few examples here. So, we have here x plus y is less than 4. We are going to determine which among the following ordered pairs will be the solution or solutions to this given linear inequality. Let us have negative 1 and 2, 1 and 6, 5 and negative 1, and 9 and negative 6. So, tingnan natin alin nga ba dito yung makakapag-satisfy sa ating linear inequality. So, we're going to substitute the value of x and the value of y. So, negative 1 is our x, positive 2 is the y. So, negative 1 plus 2, that is positive 1, and 1 is less than 4. Is it true or false? Mas maliit ba daw si 1 kaysa sa 4? Yes, it is true. So, we can consider or we can conclude that negative 1 and 2 is a solution to the given linear inequality. Next, for the second ordered pair, again, substitute the value of x and the value of y. So, we have 1 and 6. 1 plus 6 is 7. 7 less than 4, is this true? So, mas maliit ba si 7 kaysa kay 4? That is false. So, we can conclude that 1 and 6 is not a solution to this given linear inequality. Another, 5 and negative 1. So, we have here 5 plus negative 1. Again, 5 is the x value and then negative 1 is the y value. 5 plus negative 1 or 5 minus 1, that is 4. Is 4 less than 4? Mas maliit ba si 4 kesa sa 4? The answer is no. Kasi we all know 4 is equals to 4. That is why 5 and negative 1 is not a solution. Then the last, 9 and negative 6. So again, substitute it to x and then to y. We have 9 plus negative 6 and then 9 plus negative 6 is positive 3. Is 3 less than 4? Mas maliit ba si 3 kesa kay 4? The answer is yes. It is true. So, that is why positive 9 and negative 6 is a solution to the given linear inequality. So, it satisfies the linear inequality. So, sa apat na nabigay na ordered pair, dalawa dito ang naging solution sa ating linear inequality. The first one, negative 1 and 2, and then the last one, positive 9 and negative 6. Next, another linear inequality. We have here 3x plus y is greater than or equal to 3. Again, 3x plus y is greater than or equal to 3. We have here positive 1 and positive 4, negative 2 and positive 9, negative 2 and negative 5, and negative 10 and positive 4. So again, we have 4 different ordered pairs that we have to test kung alin nga ba dito ang makakapagsatisfy sa ating linear inequality. So, 3 times x, which is positive 1, plus y, which is positive 4. So, 3 times 1 is 3, and then plus 4 is 7. 7 is greater than or equal to 3. Is this true? Yes, this is true. So, we can conclude that positive 1 and positive 4 is a solution to the given linear inequality. Another, 3 times negative 2 plus 9. So, 3 times negative 2 is negative 6. And negative 6 plus 9 is positive 3. 3 is greater than or equal to 3. So, may nakalagay namang or equal to. So, we can consider this as true. So, we have negative 2 and 9 is a solution to the given linear inequality. We have negative 2 and negative 5. Again, substitute that to the given linear inequality. 3 times negative 2, that's negative 6, plus negative 5 is negative 11. Magkapareho kasi sila ng sign. Is negative 11 greater than or equal to 3? Mas malaki ba si negative 11 kesa kay 3? The answer is false. We can conclude that negative 2 and negative 5 is not a solution to the given linear inequality. Then the last one, we have negative 10 and 4. So, 3 times negative 10 is negative 30 plus 4, that is negative 26. And is it greater than positive 3? The answer is no. That is why negative 10 and 4 is not a solution to the given linear inequality. So, for this example, dalawa ulit ang naging solution, 1 and 4 and negative 2 and 9. For our last example, we have here y is less than or equal to 2x minus 3. The given ordered pairs are negative 1, negative 2, positive 1, negative 3, positive 2, positive 3, and positive 3, positive 3. So, which among the following given ordered pairs will be the solution to the given linear inequality? So, huwag kayong malilito, y yung nasa unahan, x yung nasa hulihan. So, we have to substitute it properly. Y is negative 2 and x is negative 1 for our first ordered pair. So, we have here negative 2 is less than or equal to the product of 2 times negative 1 minus 3. So, that will be negative 2 minus 3. And kapag nag-keep change tayo, magkakaroon tayo ng negative 2 plus negative 3. And the answer is negative 5. Is 2 less than or equal to negative 5? Mas maliit ba si negative 2 kesa kay negative 5? The answer is no. Mas malaki si negative 2 kesa kay negative 5. So, it does not satisfy the given linear inequality. So, we can conclude that negative 2 and negative 1 is not a solution. Next, positive 1 and negative 3. Again, y is negative 3. And then, x is positive 1. So, negative 3 is less than or equal to 2 times 1 is 2 minus 3. So, 2 minus 3 is negative 1. Negative 3 is less than or equal to negative 1. Is negative 3 mas maliit kesa kay negative 1? The answer is true. Okay, so kasi mas malapit sa negative 1 sa positive integers at kay 0. So, mas malaki siya, di po ba? So, that's true and we can conclude that positive 1 and negative 3 is a solution. Next, positive 2 and positive 3. Y is positive 3, x is positive 2. So, 2 times 2 is 4. 4 minus 3 is 1. So, we have 3 is less than or equal to 1. Is it true na mas maliit si 3 kesa kay 1? Siyempre, it is false. So, we can conclude that 2 and 3 is not a solution. The last one, positive 3 and positive 3. Substitute ulit natin. 3 ang ating y, x is 3 din. So, 2 times 3 is 6. 6 minus 3 is 3. Is 3 less than or equal to 3? So, since ang atin pong inequality symbol ay may or equal to, we can consider that this is true. Kasi nga po, 3 is equals to 3. So, therefore, we can conclude that 3 and 3 is a solution. So, for this last example, there are two ordered pairs that satisfies the linear inequality. So, sila yung dalawang solutions na meron tayo for now. So, we have 1 and negative 3 and 3 and positive 3. So, that's all for this video. So, this is all about the introduction of linear inequality in two variables. So, when we say linear inequality in two variables, halos kagaya rin lang siya ng ating linear equation. The only big difference is that the symbol we are using here are inequality symbols. And they are greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. So, that's all. I hope you learned something from this video. And huwag kalimutang mag-subscribe, mag-like, and mag-share nitong video na to. Bye-bye!